Friends, today let us learn the third unit of SOM, strength of materials. The third unit is shear force and bending moment diagrams. Shear force and bending moment diagrams. Shear force and bending moment. This is the chapter. This is the unit. Unit 3 of strength of materials. Now, this shear force and bending moment comes in beams. Now, beams are the essential parts of a structure. A structure basically consists of two members. One is called the columns and the other is called as the beams. The vertical members are called the columns and the horizontal members are known as the beams. Now, these shear force and bending moment diagrams come in beams. Now, first let us see what are the different types of beams we have. Beams are of different types. The first one is the cantilever beam. Cantilever beam. Now, if I draw a line, horizontal line, this graphically represents a beam. If it is supported at one end and not supported at the other end, then this beam is called as the cantilever beam. Now, this end is called the fixed end. Fixed end. This is called the free end. The end which is not fixed is called the free end, and this is called the span or the length of the beam. This is called the length of the beam or span of the beam. So this is the fixed end, that is the free end. Now this you must know, which end is the fixed end and which end is the free end. The second type of beam that we come across is the simply supported beam. Simply supported beam. Now, this is the beam. A horizontal line represents the beam. If I have one support at this extreme end and another support at this extreme end, then this beam is called as a simply supported beam. Now, this is called the span of the beam here. This is the span, and this is called the left support. This is the left support, and that is the right support. That is the one which is to my right, or to your right, your right hand side will be the right support, and the one which is to your left, that is called as the left support. So this is the simply supported beam. This is called the length of the beam or the span of the beam. Next, you have overhanging beam. Overhanging beam. Now, an overhanging beam also has two supports. It will also be supported by two supports, but the supports need not be at the extreme ends. They may be something like this. Now, the overhang may be only on the left side, or it may be only on the right side, or it may be on both right hand as well as left hand. Whatever it is, if these two supports, both the supports, if either one of them or both of them, if they are not at the extreme ends of the beam, a portion of the beam is overhanging on either side or on both sides, then you call that beam as a overhanging beam. Again, this is called as the left support, that is called as the right support. Now, this will be the total span of the beam. This is called the overhanging beam, and you have continuous beams. That is, continuous beam is one where you have a number of supports. Number of supports, that is called as a continuous beam. Now, problems will come to us only in these two beams, that is in cantilever beam and simply supported beam. But theory can be asked, name the different types of beams, draw a simple line diagram for these beams, that can be asked. So for this, these are the answers. Continuous beam means it will be having a number of supports, not necessarily two supports, then it is called as a continuous beam. So these are the different types of beams you are supposed to know. Next, the beams are subjected to loads or subjected to loads. Every beam is subjected to loads. Now these loads also are of different types. Loads, load on the beam, types of load. Again, this will be asked, this can be asked in theory. What are the different types of loads that we get on a beam? Now one type of load is what we call the point load. Point load, or it is also called as concentrated load. Concentrated load. Here, if this is the beam, this is the beam. If we have a load which is acting at a particular point, they will mention what is its distance from either this side or that side. They will give that distance. That particular load is acting at one particular point of a beam, then it is called as a point load or concentrated load. It may be given either in Newton or it may be given in kilonewton. That will be the unit, SI unit. Either it will be in Newton or it can be in kilonewton. If it is a bigger load, they will give it in kilonewton. If it is a smaller load, they give it in Newton. So this is called as the point load. Second one is uniformly distributed load. Uniformly distributed load, or it is called as UDL. It is shortly called as UDL, uniformly distributed load. In this case, this is the beam. This load will be spread uniformly. It will be spread uniformly over a particular length. This length will be given. This may extend beyond that. This side, it may extend beyond that. This length will be given, and they will give this load as so many Newton per meter, or it can be given as so many kilonewton per meter. What is the load per 1 meter, 1 meter length, or 1 kilo in kilonewton per meter or newton per meter length? It is distributed uniformly. Like for example, we have a beam on which the ceiling is there. That ceiling, that load of the ceiling is uniformly distributed on that beam. Then we have uniformly varying load, or it is called as the UVL, uniformly varying load. So they will, it will be, if this is the beam, over a particular length, it may start from zero, or it may be some load here and some load there. It will be uniformly varying over a particular length. This length will be given, and this, how much it is, that will be given. So this is uniformly varying load. Now, these are the different types of load. Again, this will be asked in theory. Now, in the numericals, we get only these two types of loads. We get either point load or uniformly distributed load, or both may be combined in a problem. Both point loads, they may be, a beam may be subjected to a number of point loads and also a uniformly distributed load. So these are the different types of loads that can come. Again, this can be asked for 3-4 marks in theory, 3-5 marks, like that they will ask. Then we should next find out what is the meaning of shear force. What is shear force and what is bending moment? You know, I have told you in simple stress and strain, if a load is acting, if this is a member, a column, is object, and if a load is acting approximately perpendicular to the axis of this, then that load is called as the shearing load. Here, a beam will be subjected to a number of forces. It will be subjected to a number of forces. A number of forces, or what we call the loads. What is what they call force in science, we call that as loads. It is subjected to a number of loads. Now here, what is the meaning of shear force? Shear force at any particular section, at a particular section, let us say at this point, what is the shear force acting on a beam? Now this shear force at any section, shear force at any section of a beam, at any section of a beam is the algebraic sum of algebraic sum of all the forces acting on the beam, all the forces acting on the beam either to the right or to the left of that section this is the definition of shear force. They can ask this also in theory. They can ask to write, to define what is shear force. This is how it is defined. Shear force at any section of a beam is the algebraic sum of all the forces acting on the beam either to the right or to the left of the section. Now if this is the section, let us say this is some problem, some numerical. Now at this point we have been asked to find the shear force on the beam. Now either we can take this side of the beam, or I can take this side of the beam, either left or right. Here in this case there are three forces this side, there are three forces that side also, but it need not be three only, it can be different. Now here let me call this as 3 kilonewton, this as 8 kilonewton, and this as 2 kilonewton. We normally take right side. I take right side, right of this particular section. I am finding the shear force at this particular point. Now, if you say simply sum, the sum of all the forces acting, sum means it will be 3 plus 2 plus 8, that will give me 13 kilonewton. If you say simply sum, if you say algebraic sum, what is the meaning of this? algebraic sum. Algebraic sum means what? Now you see, here I have taken only the magnitude of the forces, only the magnitude of the loads. I have taken the magnitude, I have not considered direction. When I take it as algebraic sum, I have to take both magnitude and direction. See, this force is acting downwards. A few forces are acting downwards, a few forces are acting upwards. Now, if I take these as negative, then I must take this as positive. Or if I take this as negative, these two must be taken as positive. In some books, some books take this as positive and this as negative. Some books take this as negative and this as positive. Both are correct. Both are correct. We have to follow one particular convention. We have to follow one convention. Now, for me, I take this as negative. The downward forces as negative and upward force as positive. So then what will happen is, if I take algebraic sum, it will be 8 minus 3 minus 2. That will be 3 kilonewton. The answer will be 3 kilonewton. So this is the correct way of doing it. It is the algebraic sum. Right. Whether you take it from the right or from the left, either to the left or to the right, if you have taken the values correctly, you will get the same answer whether you do it on the left side or on the right side. We generally take it on the right side. So this is the definition of shear force. When we are solving the problems on shear force and bending moment, you will come to know. You will get two problems here. About in this chapter, you will get about 30 marks. Totally around 30 marks, you will get questions for about 30 marks. You will get two problems, two numericals and also theory, right? So this you must be very careful. You must have very clear idea as to what is the meant by this algebraic sum, how to take the signs. If you take downward as negative, the upward must be taken as positive. Otherwise, it is vice versa. It will, if you take upward as negative, downward will be positive. Some books take it this way, some books take it that way. You can take it any way you want. I take it this way. So you can stick to one particular convention. You can take any convention you left to you, but I stick like this. I take the downward force as negative and the upward force as positive. Is that clear? Next, what is bending moment? Let us see. What is bending moment? I am sure you know moments. What is meant by moment of a force? This has been taught to you in science. Say, this is a member, a beam, like this, a horizontal member. Now, I am applying a force here. Now, this force is trying to rotate it. This moment of this force about this point will be this force, magnitude of this force multiplied by the distance. This is called as the moment of a force. Here also a beam will be subjected to moment. Now if I am holding it here and applying a force here, it is trying to rotate. This force is trying to rotate it in this direction. This direction is taken as clockwise direction. The direction of the moment, the direction of the force will be the direction of the force will be upward or downward. Here it will be either this way, or if I am holding it here, applying a force like this, I am holding it here and applying a force here. Now it will be anti-clockwise. One is clockwise and the other one is anti-clockwise. That is, clockwise means it is rotating, it is trying to rotate this in the direction as the clock, clock goes like this. This is called anti-clockwise, movement. Now, if I take this as positive, this must be taken as negative. We generally take this as positive and that as negative. Anti-clockwise will be taken as positive, anti-clockwise moment of a force. See, if I have a beam like this, a force is acting. If I take it at this point, this magnitude of the force, whatever Newton, kilonewton it is, multiplied by this distance. If I take the moment of this force about this point, it will be different because now the distance has increased. The moment will also increase. The moment depends upon the magnitude of the force of which you are taking the moment and the distance of that force from the point at which we are taking the moment. Now, if the point we are taking is here, the force is here, this is clockwise. And if a force is acting here, its moment will be anti-clockwise. This is trying to rotate it this way, this is trying to rotate it this way. So, this is clockwise moment, so this will be negative, and this is anti-clockwise, that will be positive. So, like this, the bending moment also has both magnitude and direction. It can be, the magnitude means the force multiplied by the distance gives you the magnitude, and it will be given in Newton meters or kilonewton meters generally, and this will be, this can be either positive or negative depending upon the direction in which it is trying to rotate the beam. If it is clockwise, it is taken as negative. If it is anti-clockwise, it is taken as positive. Here, bending moment at any section of a beam, again, is defined as bending moment at any section of a beam is the algebraic sum. Algebraic sum means this sum is taken along with the, it is not just total, it is algebraic sum means it has been added with direction, taking both magnitude and direction, is the algebraic sum of the moments of all the forces acting on the beam, either to the right, or to the left of that section, So this is the definition. If they say define bending moment of at any section of a beam, this is the definition of that. It will carry 5 marks. If you define it correctly, they will give you 5 marks. Now we will, after this, we will have to take up the numericals. We will take up a few examples from your question bank. We will take some question, this thing. In the next clip, it will be done. If you have any problems here, anything, you can ask me, you can ask for clarification. I will be pleased to tell you that. You please subscribe to this channel and share it to the maximum possible extent so that many students can get benefit out of it. Thank you.